Hey, Coach. So, with all the players you have this year, obviously there were no draft picks. Do you think you have a bit of an advantage getting players from overseas who had a bit of that pro experience already?
I don't know that we have any advantage on anybody in the sense that because we have so many new players and they're all coming in different kind of stages of conditioning, I don't know that there's any advantage. I mean, a lot of teams are going through this. I mean, I think one of the biggest problems we have is we have, several players who haven't played a meaningful game in, for Elena or Tina in, almost 2 years in a sense. And, Natasha played a little bit overseas in Italy. But, they're not in any kind of, game shape at this point. Then you have those who are going to come back late from overseas that aren't even here and will be tired from playing. And then you have kind of all the ones in the middle, who have been working on their conditioning, but nobody's been able to go up and down and play much 5-on-5. So it's really, really hard to evaluate right now at this point about where we are, but I don't think there's any advantage at all in this.
Cream.
Hey, Mike, how are you doing?
Great, thanks.
Quick question, kind of actually going off of that a little bit, can you share with us a little bit how you plan to kind of work some of these early practices, as because I know you're going to work folks in slowly, and especially Elena coming off her surgery and just, a little bit of a glimpse of the plan of how you guys will work them in slowly without pushing too hard.
Yeah, I mean, I think that the biggest thing, and I talked to our players about it in our team meeting yesterday, is that, the goal is to be at our best when you need to be the best. So let's work back from that. And, when you have players who haven't played in a while or are coming off injuries and surgeries and all those things, the worst thing you can do is to have them, be injured again or, beat up, 3 or 4 days into training camp. We don't need anybody to win, exhibition games, and we don't necessarily have to be at our best to start the season. You want to be good, but our health is one of the biggest things. I mean, once we lost Alecia Clark, that's a big time reminder to a coach that being healthy and being ready is the most important thing. And so we're going to go very gradually. We're not having long, long practices. We won't even do a lot of scrimmaging in this first couple of days. Whatever scrimmaging we've done, excuse me, we'll do, will be, mostly half court. Our full court conditioning will come without defense at the start. And so I don't know that we'll do any 5-on-5 full court basketball till the end of the week. We will go up and down full court, but we won't be scrimmaging doing any of that. And so that's the first part of the plan. The second part is, to limit the number of minutes or time on the court for some of those. Stella had surgery, Elena had a surgery. And so, be careful with those things. And then, try to kind of get everybody on the same page conditioning wise by the time we get to end of camp so that we, kind of all are on the same level of condition. There'll always be a couple who are way better conditioned because that's just who they are and they've done a better job of it. But I've watched other teams come out, kind of blazing at the start, and then be beat up and hurt. And I just, it's not worth it. So that's, I don't even know how much, the first exhibition game that we will play our veterans. They'll play some, and then we'll have a second one and we'll play them more. The other thing we haven't figured out, and it's very different for us, is we don't have our male practice players that all the teams are used to having. And so you used to be able to sub people and get them more time of rest in a practice when you had the guys in here. Now we're going against each other with, without a lot of subs once we make some cuts. And so we have to just be very careful of what we do.
And just a quickie, is Elena clear to do everything?
No, she is limited what we're doing. She's not going to do any of the 5-on-5, any of the live stuff for at least this first week, if not a little bit longer. She's been doing individual drills on the side, you know, every day during this last phase of 2 weeks with where we could do individual workouts with players. And the plan is to kind of continue that through at least the first week to 10 days. You know, I've talked to our trainer and doctors. They feel reasonably confident that she's making a lot of progress and that, you know, by our first game, she may be able to play some. But I'm not risking any of it if it jeopardizes anything. We want her to be healthy for the season. So I suspect we'll be on limited minutes for a while.
Thank you.
Kellen.
Hey, Mike, good to see you.
How you doing?
Good. The WNBA is celebrating its 25th season. You know, you've been coaching in the league for a while. How has the WNBA grown and evolved in your time with the league? And what do you think have been kind of the biggest changes in growth?
I think on the court, you know, the players have gotten bigger and faster and stronger. You know, when I first came in the league, you know, I use Asia Jones as an example, who, you know, played for me in Connecticut. She's 6'2", maybe 6'3" on a good day, but she was considered a regular post player. I mean, you had people, you know, like Lisa Leslie at the time and Margot Dedek and others who were big, and we still have that. We have, you know, Griner and Fowles and Cambage who are very big, but you now have post players who are 6'4", 6'5", who can play anywhere on the court. I think that's, you know, the NBA has seen that and we've seen that. You know, the Elena Delle Dons and the Tina Charles and the Brianna Stewarts and the Asia Wilsons and all of those kinds of players who can do so much. They affect the game. And so I think you see that. I think over the last 4 to 5 years, just like the NBA, I think you've seen better perimeter shooting. You always had good shooters in the league, but now you're getting more of them coming in the league. I still don't think where we are or where we should be with that, but I think we have better athletes who have, you know, gone through AAU systems and better conditioning and better nutrition and everything else. And they're just bigger and faster and stronger. And so it changes the game and allows coaches to kind of do more. I mean, you had a lot of post players in our league that never stepped outside of, you know, 10 to 15 feet when I first came in the league. Now you have all of them camp behind the 3-point line and can post up. So I think that's one of the biggest differences. I think the other part of it is, you know, excuse me, is more on the business side, is that, you know, early in the history of the WNBA, you know, you had a team like Washington who won all these attendance banners. You know, they had all these big crowds, but they weren't treated like a business. There were discounted tickets, there were freebies, and teams continued to lose money. I think owners have understood that there's a value to these teams, that, you know, you don't want to keep losing money. And so you're doing a better job now, you know, both at the league level and at the team level of getting true sponsorship and TV deals. And, you know, the ESPN deal has improved. Our coverage is, you can watch a game every night in our league, watch everybody play between the League Pass and CBS Sports Network and local TV and ESPN. You can watch every game. And that wasn't true at all of the league when I first came in.
Thanks, Mike.
Scott. Coach T, always good to see you. Hope all is well. Obviously, finally, a little bit of normalcy in a sense. You know, you're going to have some fans to start off. You're going to, you know, have a traditional road games and whatnot instead of this bubble life. I mean, just from that perspective, how much are you looking forward to this season in particular because of what you guys went through last year?
I'm looking forward to it a lot. I mean, just the sense that you have a little bit more freedom, particularly as more people become vaccinated. I'm glad I'm not having to manage the ticket issue with, you know, trying to figure out who gets to go to what games and how you do that on a limited number. But from a player standpoint and a coaching standpoint, the fact that you get that connection back to some degree with fans, that, you know, you're not confined to your hotel room every day. Or, you know, and we weren't confined to the hotel room. I mean, we had a campus and everything else. We could get out and walk or play tennis or whatever, but it's just a different feeling. And it's going to be particularly different. I think that by the third or fourth game of the season, we will have a fully vaccinated team, staff and players and everything else. And so that gives you a little bit more freedom, you know, when you're on the road to have a normal dinner outside at a restaurant, instead of being, you know, in your hotel trying to do room service, those kinds of things. I think that'll make a big difference. There's just a mental aspect of it that you can go home and see your family at night. And, you know, you're still going to, we're going to have to be very, very diligent. You know, I told our players in our meeting that, you know, that still the testing and the protocols take precedence on everything else, that you have to look out for your teammates and families and how you take care of yourself. Just because we're getting vaccinated doesn't allow us to be reckless. And so there's still going to have to be a sense of awareness of, you know, that this is still a pandemic that we are living in, and it's a dangerous thing. So, you know, our job is to take care of each other in this whole thing. So that's still going to be foremost, but there is a sense of, you know, more freedom and more just kind of a normalcy to your day-to-day life.
And Mike, I feel like, you know, your roster has been like one big puzzle piece already with the injuries and trying to figure out who's going to be here, who's not going to be here. What has that been like for you? Have you been like kind of banging your head on the wall a little bit already?
I'm trying not to. you know, I mean, last year, it, you know, was a huge one as far as to trying to do all that and deal with, you know, by the time Ariel Powers got hurt, being without five key players. You know, right now we're without one key one in Alicia Clark, and we'll have some others. Maisha will be here at some point from France, and we'll have, you know, Kiara Leslie will get here, you know, this week, and Erica McCall. So they'll, you know, the puzzle will get a little bit easier. We're having to work around Elena a little bit, but the good part of it is we know that she's getting better, and that will be part of it. You know, but you do have to keep recalibrating, you know, trying to figure out your offense and defense. You know, we planned a lot of our defensive stuff because of Alicia Clark being our big signee, and now that's had to change a little bit. So but you know, all seasons have an ebb and flow to them, and they have disruptions. I told our team also that, you know, the teams that will be successful are ones that can handle making changes on the fly, that can, there's going to be something that happens during a season that's a distraction or an interruption of some sort. And, you know, our job is to handle it and kind of deal with it as it comes. And the teams that do a good job of that will have a little bit better success, I think.
Thanks, Coach.
Tyler.
Hey, Mike, good to see you again. I want to talk about LaToya, and obviously with Asia Jones going to the Trailblazers, how was it? Was it a natural just let's bring her in, or was there a little bit more nuance in getting LaToya into the position? And then what does she bring as an assistant coach that you saw as a player?
Yeah, it's interesting. You know, when we brought Asia on into that same kind of position that LaToya started in this year, we brought Asia in a few years ago, and she was probably ready then or close to it to being, you know, able to be an assistant coach. You know, she was had a little bit more time to develop. LaToya's mindset is a little bit different. I mean, I think even though I don't think she ever really thought seriously up until the last year or two about being a coach, she's treated how she's gone about doing her job on the court as a coach. You know, she's kind of been the voice and the anchor on our defense. So that goes a long way with instant credibility with your former teammates. I think the other thing is that last summer, even though she didn't play, she counseled some of our players almost on a daily basis with some of them about some of the nuances and what they were facing. You know, I know Maisha used her as a sounding board all last summer. So that, I think that helped her too. And then, you know, this offseason when she retired and we hired her, we've really involved her in some of the, you know, things that we're talking about doing. And then these last couple of weeks, she was doing individual workouts with players one-on-one. And so when and I kind of knew that, you know, Asia had a chance to get this job for a few weeks now. When it actually officially happened, You know, we talked about as a staff and front office whether we would go outside to get somebody. And the consensus was we don't need to do that. She's ready. She may not know she's completely ready, but we all felt that. We watched her. We observed her. She's proactive in, giving her opinion. And I just felt she had the composure and the respect of her teammates that she could start on it right away. And so it felt very comfortable doing it. And even since that decision in the last 5 days, I don't regret it at all. It's been great.
Thank you, Coach.
And then last question to Jen.
Hey, Coach, kind of on that same topic, well, a related topic, the Liberty announced today that Jackie Jamelos is going to be an assistant coach there, and just curious to get your reaction to that move and what she'll bring.
Yeah, I just heard about it, I think probably yesterday sometime, that it might happen. I think, I don't know how they're using her on that staff and, kind of what her role is going to be, but I have felt just in that one summer of coaching her last season that she wanted to be a coach and could handle that. She's such an outgoing person. We called her the mayor, man. She knows everybody. She just, has that kind of chemistry about her that, she can connect with a lot of people. So it surprises me a little bit, this late that, right off a plane that she's got a coaching job, because I didn't know that there was an opening on that staff. But I think she has that ability to make connections with players that will be really good, and she'll be upbeat. And I think she has a good future ahead of her.
Hey, hey, what's up, Leilani? How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, 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 good. Well, let's start with, I was just thinking earlier, since you've kind of come in, your role is kind of keep shifting. It's kind of like when you came first in, you were joining, that 2019 championship team, and everybody was kind of expected to come back before obviously everything changed and you kind of got thrust back into the starting lineup. Now it looked like you would be kind of going back to almost a reserve role, and then things kind of changed again. So I'm just curious, how are you kind of approaching your role this season? Do you kind of have a feel for it, or are you kind of just used to just rolling with the punches at this point?
Yeah, I really don't know what the plans are for this season. it was only first day yesterday. Obviously, we have a big loss with Alecia going out, getting injured. I honestly have no idea, but I just come and play my game and coach knows what I can do and what I'm capable of doing. And obviously I'm going to play my hardest and do everything I can, and wherever I fit best, is whatever's going to happen. And I'm fine with that. Whatever we need to do to win is fine.
And just quickie, how are you feeling physically?
I feel good. So I finished my season in Australia at the end of December, and I've had a few months to just rest and relax, which has been good because I had some little injuries that I was dealing with. So just stayed in shape on my own and enjoyed some downtime, and I feel good coming into camp.
Thank you. We'll talk soon.
Thank you.
Jen?
Hey, Leilani. Good to see you again.
Hi, you too.
I asked Tosh about this a few weeks ago when she did media with USA Basketball, but just curious what you're looking forward to about playing with her specifically, and how you think that you guys can either play off each other or complement each other or that sort of thing.
Yeah, I'm excited to play with Tosh. Obviously she's grown up a lot, both on the court and off the court, since I played with her last, and just watching her game evolve and develop over the last few years has been fun and exciting. And she just plays with a lot of energy. Obviously she's the emotional leader of the team. She's quick to get the ball up the court, so playing with her is exciting. She's a great passer. I like to shoot three, so that'll be good to play with her, where she can get some shots for me. And I think we complement each other well, because she probably is more of a driver and creator and that sort of thing, where I probably prefer to shoot outside a little bit more. So I'm excited. I'm looking forward to it, and hopefully it's a good season.
Thanks so much.
You're welcome.
Kellen.
Hey, Leilani.
Hi.
It's the 25th season of the WNBA. You know, growing up, what are some of your early memories of the league? Like, what did the WNBA mean to you growing up?
Oh, I've got to be honest. I didn't really watch the WNBA too much growing up. I was actually thinking about it yesterday. I was like, this is my 13th year, and the WNBA is now obviously in its 25th season. So I was like, I've actually been playing in it for over half the amount of time, which is just crazy to me. But yeah, I mean, I'll be honest, I didn't really watch it too much when I was growing up.
I guess I'll rephrase the question. How has the league grown in the 13 years you've been in it?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, all the opportunities that it's created for with our platform as far as speaking up, and especially the last few years where you can look back to, I think it was maybe Minnesota was one of the first teams that stood up and took a stand, and the league actually wasn't supportive of it back then. I think that was maybe 4 or 5 years ago. And then you look at, especially last year in 2020 and all the support they gave to us. Sorry, someone coming in. all the support that they gave to us during the whole, you know, allowing us to wear the Black Lives Matters and all that. And when we made the stand against for Jacob Blake. You can just see how it's grown and how they've supported us as people, not only basketball players. And I think that's the biggest and most important thing so far.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Last question to Zach.
Hi, Leilani. What's the morale of the team like right now? I know you have a lot of positives going on. You have a great team back. Maybe the one negative would be Alecia being out. And then what's your role as a veteran leader in terms of boosting morale?
Yeah, I mean, obviously it's only the second day of camp, so everyone's excited. We're looking forward to it. Last year was a struggle, not only because of what was going on in the world and being in the bubble, but the injuries and then the people who sat out, obviously were a lot of our main players. So that was a bit of an adjustment during last season, and coming into this year, everyone's excited because for the most part, we have all of our players back. And if they're not quite ready yet, they will be soon, hopefully. And, you know, being an older veteran on this team is just leading by example and putting my two cents in when I see something that can benefit the team and make sure I express that to them. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Hey, Stella, I was just wondering where you're at physically coming into the season and how fast you think you'll be able to get up to speed.
I'm on the court, back on the court playing with everybody. They still limit me to like 100 jumps a day, but I'm still back. I can play with them. I just can't shoot extra as much as I want to, but I'm pretty much back.
Were you able to work on anything new while you were injured?
I would say like the quickness of my shot. I know Coach Thibault wanted that to change a little bit. So I just worked on, you know, setting my feet, even though I couldn't jump, but just like, you know, work on my form and all that this off season too.
Kareem.
Oh, I'm already unmuted. Hey, what's up, Stella? I just wanted to ask, you know, last year was so weird. You know, you kind of came on so strong and then the injury kind of shut everything down right when you were kind of getting going. But I'm just curious, what did you take from the whole experience last year, and how do you kind of apply that and keep moving forward for 2021?
It was weird. It was just I played and then all of a sudden, like, I wasn't there anymore. But I just took it that, like, I'm here for a reason. I'm on a team. I'm on a training camp contract for a reason. And, you know, I just got to come into camp just positive and just remember what I did back in the bubble, that I can play with WNBA stars. And just had to take it all in. You know, I'm on a team with Tasha Cloud, Elena, Del Don, and all those older people, veterans that I can learn from. So I'm just taking it all in.
Is there a level of confidence that even though it was a short stretch of time, but did you kind of get a level of confidence that, hey, yeah, I do belong here?
Yeah, I think that one game really kind of boosted my confidence. And, you know, having all the support from home and saying, oh, like, you can actually play with the WNBA, I think that also helped me perform on the court better too.
Thank you.
Last question to Tyler.
Hey, Stella, good to see you again. I know at the end of last season, Mike dubbed you the team's draft pick for this upcoming year, and then you obviously got the training camp contract. What was it like this offseason having some sort of assurance from a team that you could just, were you able to kind of relax and know that you have to dig in to get the roster, or what was that process like for you leading to the year?
I think I was a little nervous at first because when I got injured, it took a long time for me to get back and actually get the surgery and stuff. So, but hearing Coach Thibault have that belief in me, it kind of like helped me out and, you know, stay like a little more on the calm side than like panic of getting back in shape and be ready for training camp. So his words like definitely helped me, and just like the training staff too, they helped me get my confidence back into that ankle. And so, yeah, I think his words, it definitely helped.
Hi, welcome to the Mystics.
Thank you.
Just wanted to ask you, you know, what your mindset is coming into this training camp, and if you've had any, you know, kind of welcome to the WNBA moments yet, whether, you know, that's in a good way or a bad way.
As far as like a welcome, everybody here is really, really nice. And since camp has just started, it's kind of more getting into the swing of things. So I haven't had a bad moment yet, but everybody on the team is wonderful. You know, the veterans all make a point of coming and talking to everybody and checking in with everyone. So that makes it really easy. As far as my mindset, it's about controlling what I can control, being a great teammate, being an aggressive defender, and then doing the things that I do well, so which would be shooting. So focusing on just controlling those things and being the best me I can be.
Thank you.
Ariel?
Hey, go Pack. Anyway, I just want to know what it took for you to make your way into training camp, and what kind of mentality shift did you have to have post-graduation in order to refocus and, you know, get it grinding?
So for me, it was kind of a disappointment after draft night, obviously hoping and expecting kind of to be drafted. But, you know, the turnaround and focusing on the next step of how to get back here actually happened fairly quick for me. So heading to Switzerland and having a chance to play on a very talented team that also played in Euro Cup was important to me, to be able to kind of refocus my offensive abilities, and then, you know, get back into playing basketball at kind of a faster pace, at a little bit more WNBA like style. So I felt that my move to go to Switzerland was really good for that. Mm-hmm. And now I'm just excited to get started here.
Yeah, quick follow-up. Sorry. I know you've only been there for like, 48 hours at this point, but who's been your like go-to person that you've been talking to within the team to help you?
You know, I think Natasha is like kind of that for everybody. She's a really great leader and she's always a lot of high energy. But at the same time, everybody is really great. Anytime they have anything to say to you, they'll come up and they'll talk, and everybody, it really already feels kind of like a family, which is really nice and very surprising.
Hey, hey, what's up, Ariel? How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, 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 good. You know, one day into practice, I know you guys are kind of moving it along slowly, but just what was it like to be back with this group that, you know, a lot of y'all haven't seen each other for a really long time? So I'm just curious, what was it like to just, what was the vibe of having everyone back together?
Yeah, I mean, it felt good to be in a practice setting, again, specifically for me. You know, I haven't played in a little while. But as a team, it's kind of a little interesting right now because we kind of got a mix of our championship team with a mix of our bubble team. So it's really interesting to kind of see how the personalities are going to end up unfolding. But like you said, it's kind of day one. So I honestly don't have a true feel.
I know there's obviously a long way to go to kind of figuring all that stuff out. And, you know, you even said right then, you know, it's almost like a mix between that championship team and new folks.
Yeah.
I know you don't know how it'll end up shaking out, but what are the keys to you guys kind of, you know, finding that mix and finding that rhythm together as fast as possible, knowing that, you know, it's a short preseason, short training camp? You know, how do you find that mesh as fast as possible?
Going hard every day in practice and absolutely putting each other through the fire. I think that's where you really figure out who's ready, who's not ready. And some things that we need to figure out as a team, if we're good at or not good at. Coach T throws a lot of different things at us to figure out what we can and can't do, you know, as for simple terms. So definitely just putting each other through the fire and seeing where, you know, where we stand, really.
Cool, cool. Thank you.
Yeah, anytime.
Christy?
Ariel, with how you evolved as a leader from last season, both on and off the court, how do you see that meshing with, like you said, the players coming back into the fold, like Deladon and a Charles you didn't play with, and Leilani Mitchell, everybody just kind of leading in their own way, and Cloud having a big voice? How have you seen yourself as a leader in the last couple of days in training camp?
Kind of being the bridge between, like I said, the championship team, kind of some of the older players that didn't get to play with us last year, and then the bubble team. It's really weird. I'm kind of feel like my age gap is right in the middle. So just kind of being that bridge, really, and just figuring out what's good for people, what's not good for people, just getting to know people, meeting people where they're at, and just figuring out what works for us.
And a quick tag to that, do you feel that you have kind of fallen back in that way in terms of utilizing your voice because you have some big voices around you now? Or, I mean, you did it last year out of kind of necessity, like somebody needed to lead, you stepped up into that, but then now you have these big voices around you this year. Mm-hmm. Have you seen yourself like, I'm still going to be that voice, or do you fall back a little bit and let that just happen the way it happens naturally?
I'm definitely the type of person that lets things happen naturally, but I don't think that's me taking a step back whatsoever. I think if anything, it amplifies our voice as a team and as an organization.
Thank you.
Jen?
Hey, Ariel, great to see you again.
Hey.
Just wanted to ask you about one of your former bubble teammates, Jackie Jamelos, who just accepted an assistant coach job with the New York Liberty. Just curious to get your reaction to that and what you think she's going to be like as an assistant coach up there.
I mean, who doesn't love Jackie? Like, let's be honest here. I mean, there's not a person you meet you'd be like, yeah, that Jackie kid. Like, everybody loves Jackie. So I'm super happy for her. She knows the game. She's been playing for a really long time. I was definitely sad to see her retire before we got to play together this year and bring her out to DC. But again, I'm super happy for her. She's super relatable, somebody that's super down to earth. And I think the players are going to love her there.
Thank you.
Tyler?
Hey, Ariel. Good to see you again. Hope all is well. You talked at the end of last season of how the year was a big growing season for you on the court and off the court. You mentioned your leadership, and this kind of piggybacks off Christy's question as well. But now that you've had a couple of months and some time to kind of think on what you did and what was done in the bubble, mm-hmm. how do you feel about yourself and then being able to push it forward into this season?
Yeah. I'm going to assume you're talking about social justice here. Yeah.
Yeah, your social justice and your leadership being a, you meant specifically your voice and finding your voice.
Yeah, just making sure. For me, it's what I can do on the ground here in DC and finding different organizations that we can actually help as an organization. We have great owners. We have great people who believe in what we do. And so finding a way to use our resources to help others is my biggest thing. And it's not to say that I won't be vocal. You guys know me. I'm not a super vocal person. But definitely I want to take more action this year. And that's something that I'm looking forward to doing.
Thank you.
Last question to Ariel.
Hey, Ariel.
Hey.
I know that Tyler and Christine basically hit on your leadership, but I want to go a little bit deeper into it with social justice and having to be a Black woman and being the voice of us. How have you been taking care of yourself off season so that you can come into the season with a clear, you know, headspace? Because you delivered, okay?
Yeah, that's a really tough question to answer because it's something I'm still trying to figure out, to be 100% honest with you. Just with everything that's been going on, it's kind of hard to get away from it being in DC just because of the nature it is DC. So it's definitely been tough. Honestly, I've had to step back away from it a little bit just in the sense that it's a lot.
like, it is a lot, not only dealing with that stuff, but also trying to figure out like what it is that I can do to actually help people and not just say I'm helping people. And I think I kind of like bogged my mind up about that, because it's like, you see something going wrong here, you want to fix that, you want to do this, you want to do this. So just kind of dialing back and trying to figure out what is it that I can actually do versus just wanting to do everybody. Because if I spread out everything that I have, like resources and all that, everybody gets a penny versus like giving somebody a big pot and empowering that person and then like allowing them to kind of do what they do. So kind of just like pay it back, pay it forward type thing. That's just my thought process right now. By no means am I thinking that I can just step back away from it and let it be what it is. In a sense, that is a privilege that I have, that I can step out of it and relax and be like, okay, I'm not going to look at anything today. But at the foundation of it, like you said, I am a Black woman. It's something that I live day to day. And so I've got to figure out how to not only empower my people, but actually be a voice and a part of change in this community.
Hey, Blanca, this is Kellen from Washington City Paper. The league is celebrating its 25th year, or 25th season this year. And so I guess when you were in Spain, did you watch the WNBA? What were some of your early memories of the league? Like, were there players that you looked up to?
Yeah, I mean, I've been watching since I'm pretty young. I spent my last 5 years here in Maine. So, you know, since then I've been following more. So it's really special to be here, you know, at the beginning of this special season. There's so many players that I've been watching, you know, even that they are on the Mystics now with me here. So it's been really special, and I love the WNBA. So.
And yeah, I guess you said, were there specific players that you watched growing up that you enjoyed watching?
Yeah, for sure. There was like a couple of Spanish players when I was young that they were here, you know, Amaya Valdemoro, Marta Sargay, players like that, that they are very known in Spain. So those for sure, but there's definitely players like Sue Bird, like Elena Delle, Donne, you know, all these amazing women that I've been watching for a while now.
And so what's it like being on the same court as Lena right now?
I mean, it's really special, you know. It's someone that she's been here for a long time, so she really knows what this is about. You know, she's a great vet and she helps us as much as she can. So it's a special, and I'm just trying to enjoy, you know, every moment with these people.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Cheryl.
Cheryl Coward from Hoop Feed. You mentioned a couple of Spanish players who have played in the WNBA. Have you had a chance to meet any of them or get any advice from them? And also, what's the best advice you've received so far coming into training camp to help you?
I've been lucky, and I met Amaya Valdemoro, you know, in Spain. So we talked a little bit, and she told me some things she went through, you know, some advice. But I think the best advice I've got from anyone is just be myself, you know, not try to do too much or too little. Just do the little things that matter, and they're going to make a difference. And then just play how I did in college, you know, and try to help the team as much as I can.
And then last question to Jen.
Hi, Jen Hadfield from The Next. Welcome to the Mystics.
Thank you.
Just wanted to ask you, you know, you alluded to this a little bit in the previous question, but, you know, what's your mindset coming into camp? And since you've gotten to DC, has there been a moment where it really hit you, like, I'm in the WNBA and I made it?
Yeah, I mean, as I said, I think just enjoy the moment. You know, this is a crazy opportunity. I'm so blessed that I actually have this opportunity, you know, so just try to enjoy it every moment and try to learn as much as possible. I'm surrounded by great, great players, you know, they know what they're doing. So just learn as much as I can, retain everything I can. And since I got here, just being like crazy, you know, like I'm coming from a small place and now I'm here in DC with great people. So since the moment I arrived in the airport, I was like, oh my God, this is actually the WNBA, you know. So everything has been really special. And as I said, I'm just trying to enjoy every moment.
I should unmute myself first. Hey, Theresa, how are you doing?
How you doing, Kareem?
Good, good, good. Great meeting you.
Nice meeting you.
I kind of wanted to ask, you know, when you first joined, you know, Latoya was still on the roster.
You know, we didn't know what was happening with Emma. You know, now Elena, we know, is going to be worked back in slowly. I guess, how does that change kind of everything for you? Just the fact that it seems like, you know, there's going to be a need for you to, there's probably going to be a need for you to get a little bit more action kind of right out of the gate. So I'm just curious how you're kind of approaching this and approaching your role.
I'm honestly coming in with the same mindset that I try to come into training camp with every year, do the best that I can, provide everything that I can, be a good teammate, and I hope that the rest takes care of itself. I've never been a player in the league that has to had a set playing time, had a set role. I'm very good at trying to adjust and find my way. And this is a new team. I'm surrounded by really great veterans, people that have been here for a really long time. And, you know, I'm just trying to do my job, find my role, and do that the best I can. The coaching staff and everybody has been, you know, incredible in these couple player workouts that we had in the first day of training camp. So getting used to this spot here will be really nice and kind of seamless. You know, with Elena and I playing similar positions, me and Tina also doing similar things, having Latoya as a coach. I saw the shots that they get naturally within the offense here. And, you know, I'm looking forward to being able to fill those spots and, you know, do the best I can with whatever minutes or role I have.
I'm not sure how much you've gotten to talk to Mike so far, just because I know you guys just started, but have you guys kind of had a conversation and kind of talked about what he kind of envisions at all?
We've just spoken briefly about the fact that he wants me to come in and just do the best I can. After the bubble, I went back to rehab from my back surgery, and I'm coming back into the season feeling so much better. And after that, he just wanted me to feel healthy. And now that I'm here, we're working me into the offense, we're working me into different things. So I think we're going to see a progression of me being able to do different things within the offense and stuff coming soon.
That's perfect. Thank you very much. Welcome.
Thank you.
Christy?
Hey, Teresa. I know from back in the day when you were at LSU, you know, your mom is also a coach, like you've had like this tutelage. And with that being said, coming into this situation in DC, what do you think will be the biggest adjustment? And I liked how you said, like, I'm going to do whatever the team needs, but having your mom, having a coach's hat on as well as a mom hat, how has that molded you throughout your career, especially now on a new team? And the second question I have is just with the LSU change for the coach that just happened, just kind of discuss your feelings on that as well at the end.
Growing up, my mom taught me everything that I knew about basketball. I was never forced into basketball. She kind of let me organically love it. When I was a kid, I was literally in everything from like pottery to choir to I was the quarterback on my football team, all these things. And I just so happened to fall in love with basketball the same way that my mom did. And with that, I've had a really special experience being able to watch her coach. And I have been able to see the game differently. So having my mom be around and her being so heavily involved in my career has helped me drastically. And being with a father-son duo in this coaching staff, I see a lot of things that with them that I have with my mom. And it's very special. This is a great coaching staff, one of the best I've seen in X's and O's. And the way that they teach and the way that they communicate is top notch. So, yeah, I'm really excited to be working with them. And my mom is definitely going to be a part of everything that I do from here moving forward. With LSU, Coach Nikki, I played for Coach Nikki and she has a special place in my heart. I think she's going to do really great things with the Aces, and I appreciate everything that she's done for the university and everything that she's done within that time. I think Kim is going to be a really great hire moving forward. I think that, you know, she obviously has every accolade that you can imagine coming into this. So I think that, you know, I'm excited to see where the new direction of LSU goes with Coach Mulkey coming in. And she's also a close family friend. Her and my mom are really good friends. They played AAU together when they were younger. So I'm really looking forward to speaking with her and getting to talk to her and getting to know her a little bit more on a personal level as an alum to a new head coach.
Last question to Lindsay.
Yeah. Hi, Teresa. You have been documenting kind of your off-season workouts and transformation. And I wanted to ask you, you look great. And kind of as a veteran, what did you go into this off-season going? Was there specific goals that you had in mind? And kind of, I guess, just what was your mentality going into this off-season with your body?
I dropped about 40 pounds this off-season. And I honestly wasn't trying to lose any number amount. I literally just wanted my body to be as healthy as possible, and I did whatever it took for that to happen. Leaving the bubble, I still had a lot of back pain and things, and that kind of reflected in my playing time. But now that I went home and I got back into PT and I did everything, I worked out, I joined different places to try to work my body in different ways, put my body in extreme situations to try to get my back and myself as healthy as possible. And that was my main focus, just to be as healthy as possible. I was working very, very hard all the time. And that was my main focus, is just to be healthy.
And if you feel like it's impacted your game at all, have you had a chance to kind of see how it impacts, your movement and how you play?
I was talking about this to my mom when we were at home. When I first started getting shots up, I was jumping a little bit higher. And I don't want to brag or anything, but some days you can slide a piece of paper under there. Now I'm talking credit cards, you know? So I had to get used to my new vertical. It's in terms of percentages, I've like almost multiplied it times 300, you know? But in terms of everybody else's vertical, probably nothing special. But for me, I was feeling really great. Other than that, like, I feel like a lot lighter on my feet. I feel like I'm moving a little bit better. And, working myself, I didn't go overseas. So I've been by myself working out with my brother and some trainers, but getting involved with everybody else and being able to see myself on the floor is something that I'm really excited about, because I haven't been able to play with another body in a very long time. So it's really nice to be able to have teammates, and it's not as lonely anymore. So I'm very excited to be here and be a part of training camp. And, you know, this is a very special opportunity.
Just when you found out that you would be headed to the Washington Mystics for the training camp, what was your initial reaction to that news?
So my initial reaction, honestly, I was lost for words. Only thing I could do was thank God, you know, for the opportunity. Because it's a huge opportunity, and it's a blessing. It's a blessing, and that's all I could think was God.
And who was the first person you told when you got the notification? Who was the first person you ran to discuss it with?
My mom and my grandmother actually did a three-way call and told them both. So we got on the phone, and we were all just, you know, praising God for such a huge blessing.
Lindsay, did you have a question?
Sorry, no, I'm sorry.
Any last questions for Preet? I think that's it. Oh, Kareem.
Hey, I just had a real quick one. You kind of talked a little bit about kind of what this means, but I'm curious, how do you kind of approach this stuff? You know, when you join a roster like this with so many kind of accomplished folks on the team, and obviously they're just a couple years removed from a championship. I'm just curious, how do you kind of approach it, and how do you kind of try to, you know, catch coach's eyes? How do you kind of try to stand out a little bit yourself? Just when you've got, you know, two, three weeks of practices.
Right. So the biggest thing is for me is just being a sponge, taking in from everyone I can, as well as, you know, being on top of the things that I need to perform at a good level, whether that's defensively, you know, knowing how they play defensively, what they're looking for offensively, and, you know, just doing my part on that end. But it's just being a sponge is the biggest thing, taking in everything that I can from vets.
Cool. Thank you.
Thank you.
And then last to Ariel.
Hi. First of all, your spirit is so refreshing. So shout out to you for being here and making me smile today. But in a short time you've been in training camp, who have you leaned into the most or who have you learned the most from?
So as you said, it is a short time, but I really look up to Tasha and A. Just seeing them on the floor and, you know, their movement and just seeing that they have everything. Well, to me, like everything, you know, they just know exactly what it is the coaches are looking for and everything. It just really drawn me to them. And I want to, again, just be a sponge and take in so much from all of the events that's on the floor, you know, with the time that I have here that God bless me with. So that's what I'm just going to continue to do.
Hey, Tina, how are you? Welcome to DC officially now. And with that being said, I know it's only been a couple of days, but Coach Thibault said, you know, there are no practice players this year, which is going to be totally different than past seasons. But what has it been like the last couple of days just trying to get acclimated to all the new pieces here in DC finally?
It's been good. You know, for me personally, just been, I got here a week earlier. So I've just been doing individual workouts with the coaches, getting a feel for the system, little things here and there. But I mean, everyone has started to trickle in. Everybody's looking forward to the season, but it's been good.
And just to tag that quickly, what things do you foresee for this team? And I know it's been just a short amount of time, but what kind of edge do you think this team will have headed into the regular season?
I think it's definitely going to be a progression. You know, obviously it's out there with Elena. Obviously Emma is not here. Aisha Hines-Allen is not here. So I think it's going to be a progression. I think as players start to come in, you know, we still have to focus on whichever group is out there, what's going to make us successful as that group reflects. So it's going to be a progression. I think there's going to be different looks, but that's why Coach T is such a great coach. He's been in these positions before. He knows how to put individuals in the best position for them to be successful individually and for collectively as a team. So I don't think it's going to be any challenge barrier for him.
Thank you.
Kareem.
Hey, Tina, how are you?
Hey, how you doing?
Good. It's been a long time since you played ball. You know, we're talking over a year. I'm just curious, how are you feeling? How do you kind of get back into that groove of a normal season? I mean, obviously, you know, you've had a long career, so I'm assuming it's not going to be that difficult to kind of find your way back in. But I'm just curious, what's it like having had such a long stretch off? I'm assuming it's probably the longest you've had in, you know, probably since college or something like that.
Yeah, probably since never. it's definitely, have a lot of angst for different reasons, new team, new system, you know, players, nervousness, but I'm just going to go out there and play. I think that's just when I'm at my best, when I'm not thinking about anything. And I just let the game come to me, pick my positions, try to serve my teammates vocally in any way that I can. And I think any great player knows you get into yourself once you can dominate on the defensive end, and then everything else will happen on the offensive end. So I'm just going to start with defense, being vocal, being there, just playing my role, rebounds, running the floor hard, and everything else will come. It's not really anything to think about. I think it's like riding a bike in a sense.
And I know this is a super early question to ask, and you know, it's only been a couple of days, but, you know, what's the early work with Elena like? You know, I know she's still only doing individuals on the side, but, you know, what's that relationship between you two and how's that growing?
It's definitely a mutual respect, very cordial. You know, we joke around saying, I guess it was meant to be. You know, we were supposed to play together at UConn, and, you know, she made her own decision, but I think we have a mutual respect for one another, or I know we do. We're looking forward to playing. It's not a lot of time spent just due to the times that we're in the gym, due to the COVID protocol. But I know as the season progresses, I'll get to know her more personally. And, you know, I could just go over my experiences with USA basketball. It's always been great to take the court with her. It's always been natural. So looking forward to that.
Cool. Thank you.
Scott.
Hey Tina, welcome to Washington. Glad to have you on the Mystics. Obviously, you've had such a almost legendary career in the WNBA, league MVP, rookie of the year, multiple All-Star games. What keeps you motivated? What keeps you hungry, Tina?
As you did not mention, I do not have a championship. So yeah, that part right there. So yeah, that's what keeps me hungry. That's what keeps me motivated. That's what makes me want to continue to get better. And I would be remiss if I didn't mention just the players coming to WNBA. Everyone's getting better. You know, they force me to have to be in the gym just because of the level of competition that's coming in. You know, I don't take my position for granted. I don't think that I can not have a position in the WNBA. So I'm very humble in that respect. So I will have to say just the talent coming in and just wanting to win a WNBA championship one year.
You know, you've obviously have watched this team from afar, the Mystics. And what are you most excited about, Tina, about joining this team, by joining these group of women? Anything in particular?
Just playing with unselfish players. You know, I think that's the one main thing about DC, just how unselfish they are. Just how selfless they are, just how they love to share the basketball. It's great basketball, and that's because there's a great coach behind them in Coach T, where everyone celebrates one another's success. That's something that, as easy as I can say it, is not something that comes as easy into every locker room. So I'm looking forward to having that experience and just getting to know everyone and just getting better as a person as well.
Thanks, Tina. Welcome again.
Tyler?
Hey, Tina, welcome to DC. I hope all is well.
Thank you.
One thing I want to ask, again, I know it's only been a couple of days, but when you were last playing the WNBA, you were going against LaToya Sanders on the court, and now she is one of the coaches on the staff. What has that been like the past 2 days with her and working with her?
I mean, I think it's just a title change. I don't think she's changing as a person or her demeanor or how she is. Very easygoing, very communicates. Again, it literally has just been 2 days. So, you know, the most I can say is I think it's just been a title change, and I think she's going to still approach it business as usual to whatever Coach T needs and whatever the player requests from her.
Lindsay?
Hi, Tina. Obviously, last year was didn't go quite as planned after you signed with the Mystics, but you've always been on the forefront of the quest for racial justice and speaking out against WNBA. And I want to know what it was like watching what was going on in the bubble and watching, you know, players like Ariel Atkins and all have such a leadership position in that movement.
It was very great to see the change, the progression from 2016, from where they were WNBA player wise, and then 2020, you know, seeing the partnership with the Say Her Name campaign and African American Policy Forum. And as you mentioned, you know, Ariel Atkins and other individual players coming into their own and using their voice, you know, using the media and making sure that we were continue to putting on the forefront, Black Lives Do Matter. So it was really beautiful to watch as a fan and just see these women come into their own and stand for. And I always say, you know, we're not the guests of the party, we've always been the host, and they did a great job.
Thank you.
Zach.
Hi, Tina. I wanted to ask you about Myesha Hines-Allen. Just what are your thoughts on what she was able to accomplish in the bubble last year? And what do you do to give her more confidence that she can duplicate that success?
Just gonna tell her to keep doing what she was doing. You know, I don't think she needs much from me. I think she's definitely came into her own. I think once you have confidence, I think the sky is the limit. And she took hold of the opportunity last year, and it was great for her and other players who were able to get that opportunity that normally maybe wouldn't have had that luck or that opportunity if it was a normal year, you know, with everyone else playing. So I'm glad that everyone can see what she can do. And I just know she's gonna continue to do it. I don't think she needs much from me. I think she's doing great.
Hey, Shug, welcome back, number one. I know last year you came in midstream to the team, but then really made your mark. And without any draft picks this season for the Mystics, I know that coach is really relying on young talent like yourself to come in and really continue to impact the team. I know it's only been a couple of days, but where have you seen your place at the table in that regard?
I just see myself like last year, coming in, just learning from the vets. We have really great point guard vets, Leilani Mitchell and Tasha Cloud. So, you know, I'm just coming in and learning from them. And just kind of help them out and help the team out on defense. I think that's one big thing that I'm going to come in this season with, is just coming in on defense and giving energy for the team.
And the experience that you gained last year, how do you think that level of confidence has carried over to this season for you?
Yeah, my confidence is really high. I came in last year confident, but this year is like times 10. So I'm ready.
I love it. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Hey.
Kareem.
Hey, hey, Shook. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Almost kind of building off what Christy said, I wanted to look back to last year, and I know you said, you know, you took a lot of confidence from that, but that's kind of what I was going to ask, you know, what is the biggest thing you took from that whole experience, considering it was, you know, a very unique experience for everybody, and, you know, the way you kind of joined and kind of got thrown right into the fire. I'm just curious, you know, what did you take from that experience, you know, both kind of as your player, as a player, and for your growth moving towards into this year?
Yeah, so coming into last year's season, going into the bubble, like in the middle of the season, it was exciting for me. I came in with confidence, and I kind of made it like it was a training camp for me. I didn't have a training camp last year, so I came in like just trying to learn from all the vets and, you know, trying to get better. And I think Coach told me, like, he told me everything I need to work on for this year. And, you know, I just took it into account for myself to work on that during the summer and then just come here with a lot of confidence with the work that I put in the summer.
What was that summer focus?
Summer focus was just working on my shot, getting a consistent shot, and then just working on defense and, you know, coming off ball screens tight enough and working on my reads off of ball screens and everything that I need to do as a point guard.
Good. My first question will be is, missing that season, what did you get out of that, sitting out last season because of COVID and many other reasons, and now coming back to the game that you love and you played now for so long?
Yeah, it was definitely different, sitting out of my first season and just not having that season to work towards. Obviously, before I've had injury or illness and have still been focused on like getting back. But for me, the season off was like a time to learn my body more and more and get awareness of, you know, my physical health, my mental health, and to also just take time out with my wife, where we don't always get that time together. COVID was a time where we got to spend tons and tons of time together and we enjoyed one another. And now it's time to get back to it. And it's so different because you win a championship and you expect to like go back the next season, and you know, whether you say you're defending it or you're gonna try to go do it again, to not have that experience is kind of different. And then now coming into this training camp, right now we only have, I believe, 4 people from that championship run with us right now, so it's fun, it's a whole new challenge, and I'm just trying to continue to lead as best as I can.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Scott.
Elena, good to see you as always. I remember, you know, covering you out of high school, and you actually took time away from basketball. You actually played volleyball your first year at Delaware. And I know these are different circumstances of you being away from the game, but you came back to the basketball court better than ever, re-energized, refreshed. Wondering if that's a kind of a similar comparison in terms of you're just so excited and kind of you hit the reset button and you're re-energized to get back on the court.
Of course, I'm so excited to get back out there. Just trying to continue to gain strength, gain body awareness. I'm moving differently and trying to just figure out new ways to move my body that do not put pressure on my spine and other issues that we've been able to kind of clear up and clean up. So I'm excited about a new me, a new season, and just getting back out there and being able to compete with my teammates.
You know, we were talking to Coach T earlier about how this roster's kind of been one big puzzle piece already with injuries and trying to mix and match. What do you think of this team so far? Obviously, you know, there's a lot of unknowns still in terms of who's going to be playing, who's going to be available, but the expectations, I assume, still the same of winning a championship, right?
Of course. That's the Mystics way. We always say gold standard. It's just how we carry ourselves, how we approach each day, each practice, moments with one another in the locker room. So that is certainly always the goal. If I ever enter a season and the goal isn't that, I think that's the time I need to hang up the shoes and call it quits. So, yeah, I mean, we have some incredible pieces to this puzzle. And if all goes well and people can stay healthy or get healthy, it could be a scary team.
Thanks, Elena.
Kareem.
Hey, hey, Elena, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, 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 good. I want to ask about-
The wall behind you?
Yeah, I got a small problem.
I like that, I like that. I have that problem too.
Small problem, they're all over the place. I wanted to ask about this process of coming back. You know, Mike said, you know, it's going to be, he's going to take it slow with you. It sounds like you're not going to be doing teamwork probably at least this first week. And then even when the season is kind of, when we start, it sounds like you'll be on limited minutes. From your perspective, could you just share a little bit of that process of how you feel, how you kind of come back and know, hey, you know, I'm sure there's going to be days where you wake up and really feel sore and things like that. So I'm just curious how you're balancing that and how you're working through that that whole comeback process.
Yeah. So for me, it's just about right now, I've been working with some amazing people that are just helping me learn to move properly, to even walk differently, sit differently. And it's made me just move so much more efficiently, and it's helping me to get back to where I feel safe. I'm feeling good. Obviously, I know I'm going to have aches and pains. I think I'm a player who everybody knows I've played through a lot of stuff, but it's just knowing when it's healthy to play through it and when I feel strong and confident enough to keep going. But I have just an awesome staff behind me that helps me. I'm one who usually you have to like calm me down because I want to keep going. I want to keep pushing. That's just kind of in my nature. So everybody's kind of just calming me down at the moment and helping me work through this moment to get back safe and healthy. It's not a sprint, you know, it's a marathon, and I need to be right for when we need it.
And I'm just curious, you know, like you said, it's a very much different roster than the one that you left in 2019. But at the same time, you know, you've seen Maisha kind of grow into a new role, and you've seen Ariel grow, you know, take steps forward in her game. And now you're playing alongside Tina. As different as it is there still kind of like a, yo, even though folks may not be talking about y'all as much, it's 2019. Are you still like, yo, we're still here. We're still pretty deep.
Yeah. I mean, I'm thrilled about my teammates and the different weapons we have both offensively and defensively. So I feel like we're in great shape. You know, even if we're going under the radar right now, for some reason, I am super excited about the pieces we have.
Cool. Cool. Thank you very much.
Pepper.
Hi, Elena. It's great to talk with you. Hope you're well. As one of the leaders of this team, even though you're not able to play right now, what are you doing to help this team develop camaraderie and chemistry?
Great question. Yeah, so with COVID, it's like super tough too to have these like outside team meetings, getting people together. So I'm trying to find ways where we can build that camaraderie. I think the first thing is just being with one another in the locker room. In moments like this with media day, like hanging out when we're waiting to get our photos taken. And from there, hopefully as long as COVID and protocols work out, I love to do things outside of the gym where we can hang out with one another, whether it just be at someone's house. But for now, we're just doing as much as we can in the building and building on and off the court camaraderie.
Thank you. I look forward to seeing you out there.
Thank you.
Tyler.
Hey, Elena. Good to see you again. Hope all is well.
Thanks.
First question, just overall, how are you feeling being back, being doing these drills with the team? Just overall, what do you feel like your body health is at?
I'm feeling good. And every day I feel like I'm adding and continuing to build. Some days it might feel like small steps, but when you've had back surgery, you know, like, okay, I need to listen to my body a little bit more. So I'm being smart, I'm building strength, and I'm working with the best people possible. So I feel like I'm in a really good place right now, and I'm excited to just be here with my team. Like it's been a long time, and it's so nice to have everybody around. And I feel like just the energy is something I've missed so much.
And you mentioned you learned a lot in this past year about what to do with your body and how to, like you mentioned, how you walk, how you're able to sit to be able to help yourself. What else have you learned about your body to help carry yourself forward?
I've also learned about the mental side of things. I've always, you know, kind of been involved in that, especially with our coach, who is just so good with meditation and being someone who I can just dump things off of. So I know obviously it's important to physically, you know, take care of your body, whether it be the modalities or whatnot. But I also know this is just as important. So to never forget about the mind time and training your mind.
Thank you.
Lindsay?
Yeah, hi, Elena. I was just wondering, when you're looking at the schedule this summer, now that you're kind of figuring out, are you hoping that the Olympics is going to be a part of that? Is that still something that's on your radar? I know you haven't been with Team USA in a while because of your injuries.
Yeah, I am certainly hoping, you know, if they want me, I would love to be there. Being a part of Team USA is such an incredible experience. So I certainly am looking towards the Olympics and would love to be a part of that.
Just one more question. Just last summer watching what was going on in the bubble as far as, you know, fighting for racial justice and seeing the Mystics be such a big part of that.
Yeah.
What were your feelings and thoughts watching all of that unfold?
I mean, I was first of all so proud. Me and Tosh and Toya were a part of a lot of, you know, their talks. Even though we weren't there, we felt like we could be there to help support them and what they were going through and decisions that they were willing to stand up and make. And I was just so proud of the growth of especially some of the rookies who were there when I started off, and for them to just come into their selves and to speak so much from the heart and so honestly. Like, I mean, it brought me to tears watching little A in her interview, especially after the game, they decided to sit out. Like, I probably shouldn't keep calling her little A, but she's little A to me. She always will be.
Last question.
Thank you, Elena. I'm glad you're back.
Thank you.
Sorry, Lindsay. Last question to Christos.
Hello, Elena from Greece. Hope you are doing well.
Thank you.
I would like to ask you, what would you name as the biggest challenge of the next season for you personally, and how special will going to be that season for you and the team?
I mean, the biggest challenge for me is just health and getting back on the court, and hopefully getting back into my old self and knowing to just be patient with this process. It's been a while, and I'm working through new movements. I'm working with a new back, hopefully a better back. But that's what I'm focused on, but just continuing to lead and have an impact, throughout this entire process, even the moments where I'm not in a full practice. So that's my goals right now, and to try to take things day by day and not look too far into the future and just be present.
And for you, as one of the most competitive players in the game, what was the toughest part to sit out and watch the other players play in the bubble? How difficult for you was that?
It was super difficult not being there and not being a part of, especially so much of the social justice and the season for Breonna Taylor. Like, that was something it would have been amazing to be a part of, and something I certainly missed out on. I felt like our teammates did the best they possibly could to keep us involved and feeling a part of it. But it was hard to miss out on such an iconic season like that.
Me unmute. Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. I'm just curious, you know, this is, you know, a stacked roster. I'm just curious, how are you are approaching this training camp, and how are you kind of finding your moments to, and I know it's early, you know, you guys have only had like one practice so far, but, you know, just curious of, you know, how you're approaching it and how you want to, you know, quite frankly, catch the coach's eyes.
Right. Honestly, I'm just approaching it with confidence. I know where I've been. I know the work that I've put in to be here. And I think Coach T only brought me here because he believes in me as well. So I'm just excited to learn from, you know, the players I'm around, Tina Charles, Elena Deladon,
Maisha Hines Allen and just get in here and work hard. I mean, at the end of the day, it's basketball. We're all playing. We're all doing the best we can. And, you know, that's all we can do. And then let the coaches do the rest.
Is there anything specific that you're out here trying to show?
Honestly, just to show that I'm 100% healthy, I'm 100% back to the player I was before my injury and even better.
Cool, cool. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Christy?
There we go. Hi, Jillian. How are you?
Good, how are you?
You're going to say something there. With what you said about being healthy and that's what you want to prove, just overall, tactically, what are the things that you want to set in place in terms of who you are as a player and a young woman in this training camp this year with the Mystics?
Tactically, I mean, I just want to show exactly basically what you said, just who I am as a person. I'm a good person, I have a kind heart, that I'm a tough player. As a woman, I can do anything I put my mind to. I know that's been really the big message for us female athletes this year. And, you know, it just started pretty recently. So just going out there and being strong, being bold and being who I am, and bringing whatever needs to be brought for the team from my end.
And how has that felt for you in the last couple of days in the training camp?
It feels good. The team is awesome. Everyone's super open. I love everyone's energy, and I think everyone's very welcoming of each individual, and you just got to find what sets you apart from everyone else, and the team encourages you either way, so that's great.
Hey, Tosh, how's it going?
Hi, Twin. It's going good. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Oh, I'm good. I'm trying to get through this training camp, okay?
All right. So I know that there are fewer players from the championship in 2019. So based on that, do you feel like your role on this team has changed?
Yes and no. You know, while we have a different team, we still have our core. We still have players that are some of the best in our league. So while I have to be 1% better, I don't have to put this team on my shoulders, because we have players that are able and willing to step up. And I think we saw a lot of what our younger players could do last season in the wobble. So I'm just really excited to be back, but I'm just trying to be myself and, you know, get better each day.
All right, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Tell your family I said hello.
All right.
Scott?
You know, I hate following Pepper because she's always so good. This is like the second time I had to follow her. So
how do you follow Pepper?
I don't know what's going on here, but Tosh, is always good to see you. Just explain your hunger and your motivation being away from this group of women, being away from the WNBA. Explain that for me, Tasha.
I'm excited to come back. Y'all know I've been an underdog my entire career, and I still think, even winning a championship and leading this organization to a championship, I still don't get the respect that I deserve. So I think Steph Curry is the one that said it. I don't have anything to prove to anyone else, but I have a lot still I want to accomplish.
And a quick follow-up here. Obviously, you know, we've talked to Elena and we've talked to Coach T about kind of this roster puzzle piece, because you've had some injuries, you have some new faces, you don't know what the deal with Emma is going to be. So when you look at this roster, when you look at kind of this team on paper, what excites you most about this team?
Our versatility. You know, even though we have some people out, you know, we've lost some people to injury, we still have a really scary team on paper. And so right now it's just fine tuning, adjusting to each other, figuring out our strengths, our weaknesses, and really just gelling. But I think we're being kind of swept under the rug, which I like that, because the last few years we've had a target on our back. But I think we're going to shock a lot of people in this league. And you know me, that's the underdog mentality. So we're ready.
Thank you much.
Of course, Scott. Thank you.
Cream.
What up, Tosh? How are you?
What's up, Kareem? Sorry, I just saw my girl Ari on here too.
Ari, I was like, dang, what'd I do?
I'm like, keep sliding over after you ask your question, so I'm sorry.
No, it's all good. I actually want to kind of build off something you just said a minute ago. You know, you said it's basically, you know, trying to find a way to gel and getting to know, you know, some of the new faces and kind of the new way that you guys are going to play. Curious, you know, how do you... what's the quickest way to do that, considering I know Mike is going to bring everybody kind of along slowly. Elena is going to be limited minutes, you know, so it's kind of like, you're coming along slowly, but at the same time, you want to gel as quick as possible. How do you strike that balance?
Off the court, first and foremost. If y'all know that I'm going to be there for you off the court, it's always going to translate to on the court. And, you know, getting to know each other on the court, that's the easy part. You know, we just get to go out and play. I think Coach T does a really good job every year of our training camps. We don't really put in plays. We kind of just, you know, run open sets, and we got to figure out how to gel with each other that way. So for me as a point guard, you know, first and foremost, creating those relationships off the court, and then just figuring it out. Like, we're going to make mistakes in training camp, and this is the time to do it, so that when games roll around, okay, we got all that little bit of a rust or just learning each other, we got it out of the way, so that by the time games come, we're good.
And, you know, you've always been, you've been a leader on this team for a while, and we know that you're not shy and you're going to speak your mind. But a lot of the younger players we've talked to so far has been very adamant about how much you've helped them in, you know, in this very short time already. Is that something that, is it just natural and just you, or is it even another step of being, you know, taking another step forward as a leader and making sure that you're, you know, involving all the new faces?
I think it's both my genuineness of just, you know, wanting other people to succeed, because there's enough success to go around for all of us. And then also just stepping into the leadership role. I think it was my wife that was like, oh, you were a vet now. And I was like, dang, like, I really am on this too. But for me, like, even telling Pri out there, listen, whatever you need, I'm here for you, however I can help. Like, it is my job to pass on my knowledge, my experience, so that I leave this, you know, sport and this league better. And so I understand that, and I don't want to be a selfish player. Like, there's enough success to go around for everyone.
That's perfect. Thank you. We'll chat some more soon.
All right. Thanks, Kareem.
All right.
Darren.
Hey, what's going on, Tasha? How are you?
What's up, handsome man? How you doing?
you're not going to get me blushing.
Like, he always got the clean cut. Look, I got him blushing. It's all good, y'all.
we're talking to EDD, she was talking about her coming back after, you know, missing the season, and, you know, it's like four people from the championship team. I'm wondering, like, what was your reaction when you walked in and you're looking around? You're like, whoa, okay, I've been gone for a year, but all these new faces and faces that you were familiar with are now gone.
Yeah. It's always hard, you know, because this team's a family, and we really mean that when we say it. So when you lose players like AP and Tiana and even Shatori, you know, the last year, like, you know, that hits you a different way. But at the end of the day, we just want to see our people succeed. And so we're always happy for them. We always support them. And then coming into new faces, we're welcoming. Welcome to this team. Welcome to this environment. Welcome to this family, because what you're going to get here, I don't necessarily know you're going to get any. I don't know if you're going to get it anywhere else. So while it's sad in a sense, because you do create those relationships and those lifelong bonds, it's a business, and we all know that. And so we got to be able to adjust, and we got to be able to welcome and bring new people in, show them the culture, show them the way and what we've created. And this is a championship team. So that's a set tone from the jump.
And just one quick question. You skipped a year to focus on, you know, social justice. How do you plan to balance that this year now that you're back on the court?
I love that question, because a lot of people, some people have come at me sideways like, oh, so what's different this year? What's different is I laid all my groundwork this past summer. So I have everything implemented that I need to have. I have the grassroots organizations. I have, you know, the different players that I've teamed up with, and everything is fully functioning. And so it makes it my job easier of being a champion on the court, but also off the court. So I'm able to give 100% of myself at practice, and then also still give 100% of myself with what I've already laid down for the groundwork over this past summer.
Thanks, Tasha.
Appreciate you.
Ariel.
Hey, boys!
Oh my God, listen, okay.
Look, after Tosh, after. Okay, but Kareem almost took my question, but he didn't. So a lot of players said that they leaned into you whenever I asked them. I'm like, who's been holding you down for the past like 48 hours? And they were like, Natasha. So what you been telling them, and what do you see in the training camp candidates this year?
Man, we have really good players here.
that's the first and foremost, not only good players, but good, like, genuine people. So it's been a joy to be around them for the 48 hours, whatever it may be, because mm-hmm. we're separated while doing individual workouts. But we have a lot of talent here and just a lot of genuine people. And so for me, it's whatever you need. Like, I want you to be able to feel comfortable walking up to me, asking me questions, and just, you know, putting some calms to nerves too. Like, this is, you know, a nervous time, people trying to come in and show out, but just being there to help guide them, to help relax them, and just be like, hey, just do you. What you've been doing got you here, so continue to do that.
They grew up so fast. And a follow-up question. I'm doing a soundtrack to WNBA 25. Give me your top three right now. Get hype songs for a training camp.
Oh, Lord. Girl, you know I'm an R&B girl.
And that's fine. You can get hyped to some slow jams.
Hold on. I got my phone right here. Don't worry. Okay, let's do it. Uh-huh. Okay, Rod Wave. Okay, I don't know why Street Runner has been speaking to me, but
go ahead. I'm
fascinated, okay? Mm-hmm. Let's go to Justin Bieber, because too much, I don't know why I got me. And let's go, oh my God, Janae, Born Tired, stop playing with me. I don't know why.
Stop playing with you, Tosh. Okay. Me. Look, period. Okay.
For me, okay, I love her. I just want to be adopted into, like, her and the big, you know, Big Sean family. Tell me what you want me to do. Can't tell me to shut up, y'all. No, I'm just playing. Any other questions?
Last questions to Rob.
OG, what's up, Tosh?
What's up, OG? How you doing?
I'm good, man. I can't complain. Good to see you, man. Glad to see you back.
Man, if y'all ain't know, Rob helped me get to this point, because, listen, wasn't no one talking about me in college but Rob.
Appreciate that. Hey, just real quick, when did you learn about yourself last year, you know, just sitting out and doing all the wonderful work you did last year? What did you learn about yourself, and how do you feel you've grown as a woman in that period from the last time you stepped off the court as a champion to coming back now?
I think I stepped into being a queen. Like, I'm not trying to be funny, but, you know, when I encounter people now, it's, hey, king, hey, queen. And I really feel like I embrace that in every facet of, you know, just being strong and being relentless, understanding who I was and what I was about. And, you know, it wasn't easy what I did this past summer, especially in the traumatic time of being Black in America. But just understanding that, you know, what was going on in our country was much bigger than myself, much bigger than this game of basketball, and that I could be much more than just, you know, the point guard for the Washington Mystics.
Well, I appreciate that. Thanks.
Of course.
Thank you, Tosh.
Okay, I'm getting yanked, y'all. Deuces. What's your Christy? Christy, hey. Got one more. Hey.
Can I get one?
Listen, really go, Christy, real quick.
Super fast. Okay, thank you. With this being a season without a Chrissy Tolliver on the floor, do you see some similarities between how Coach Thibault will utilize you tactically in the system with both of you on the court at the same time instead of one coming in for the other at the one?
Me and Leilani?
And Leilani Mitchell.
Yes, yeah, no. So I played with Leilani. I think it was my second year. Yeah. And I loved her. And unfortunately, we just didn't have the cap space to keep her the next year. But so I'm really excited to get back with her. It is like that 1-2 punch that we had here with me and Chrissy. And I'm just really excited to make Leilani's job a little bit easier too, to have her be able to come off of ball screens and down screens and all that stuff and just find her and get her easy shot. So I'm excited for the 1-2 punch coming.
Yeah, just how's it feel to be in DC, be getting on the court and, you know, getting the training camp underway?
It feels amazing. This is my second training camp contract with the Mystics. And, you know, every time I come here, it feels like home. I love being here. I love the environment. I love the team chemistry. So I'm very excited to see what this year's training camp brings me.
Any other questions for Jamaris? Kareem?
Sorry, I'm slow with the hand raising. Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, 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 good. Quick question. I'm just curious, you know, it's like you said, second camp apparent contract with the Mystics. How do you approach it? You know, what are you, obviously Mike knows you a little bit more, but what are you trying to show? What do you want to put on tape in these next couple weeks?
I just want to show, you know, how my game has matured from 2019 when I was in training camp till now. You know, just not putting so much pressure on it, just coming in, and they brought me here for a reason. So just coming in and really being able to show them my skills and, you know, what I might be able to bring to the rest of the squad, you know, just coming in and doing my thing with no pressure on it.
Okay. Detail that for us a little bit. You know, how has your game matured?
I think last time that I was here, I was specifically a back to the basket post player, just understanding, you know, the way the game is evolving and being able to stretch my game out a little bit more, being able to guard different positions on the floor. So I've been able to evolve in that way over these last 2 years.
Cool, cool, perfect. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Alex?
Hey, Jamaris. Alex with NBC Sports and On Her Turf. Curious, just could you describe like what the last couple of years have looked like for you in terms of training and just kind of staying motivated towards a goal and just how it's felt, feeling like, is this ever going to happen?
Yeah, it's been very, very challenging, especially, you know, with COVID hitting and everything shutting down, trying to find time to get in the gyms. You know, sometimes you got to sneak in, get in where you can fit in, and just, you know, staying motivated, staying locked in, and just knowing that if I continue to work hard and do the things that I need to do for my career, that my time will come.
I just want to ask about, you know, how are you approaching this camp? Obviously, you know, this is a team with a ton of veterans and it's pretty deep. So I'm just curious how you're approaching it, what you want to show, what you want to put on tape.
I think the biggest thing for me right now is to be a sponge. Like you just said, there's just so many weapons on this team, a lot of veterans coming back. I'm trying to get in where I fit in, wherever the coach needs me, where I need to be a better, a practice player, whatever it may be, whatever I can bring to the table is what I want to try to do with that energy, get more O-boards, which pushes them harder in practice to crash it harder during game time, anything, to be honest, anything coaches need.
Cool, cool. Well, thank you.
Ariel?
Hey, walk us through the past 2 days of training camp. Give me the vibes, all that.
I'm a goofy kid. I know me personally, with my background and where I come from, this right here is a blessing in itself just to be here. I don't really know. Like, it's just.
I want you to talk a little bit more about that. What does it mean to you to be in the training camp then?
Like I said, it's a blessing. Everybody's bet against me. There's many times where I didn't even think I was going to make it out of my neighborhood. So to make it out of my neighborhood, make it big, I guess I say make it big, well, neighborhood hero is what we call it. Mm-hmm. And to eventually come back home and even get invited to a training camp at home is huge for me.
So now what do you have to prove?
I belong at this point. No more. Ifs, what ifs, hopefully I make it. I'm determined to get in this league, whether it be in this uniform or the next, but I'm going to be in this league for sure.
First of all, welcome to DC. And I know, you know, you've had great numbers when you were playing overseas this past season.
Yes.
What do you think has evolved in your game? I mean, you came into the league in 2009, right? So where would you... Yes, I know, right?
Yes.
But I love it. But you bring so much experience and great positive energy to the table. But how have you personally evolved and how have you prepared for this moment, this season in DC?
I think, you know, last year not playing in a bubble, well, the wobble, it allowed me to actually work on my game, work on things that I knew I had to improve in. And one of those things was my 3-point shooting. I think everybody knew I could go to the basket. I had a mid-range game. I like to draw fouls to get to the free throw line. But just extending my game a little bit more was what I was really focusing on. And I think last summer prepared me, you know, for the offseason that I had overseas in Turkey. And I think that's what, you know, kind of motivated me to be better. Because, you know, everybody think you know it all or you got it all. But there's always room to improve. And I think I just showed that I can improve as long as you put the work in.
Thank you.
Ariel?
Z?
What up?
How does it feel to be back, first of all? And second of all, what have you been telling the new people, the training camp candidates, I guess?
It actually feels great being back, especially with COVID and how, you know, different countries have their different rules of how they're going to test you, how they're going to try to keep you safe. Towards the end of our season this year, COVID, it was a bad COVID outbreak with every team that was in the playoffs, and our team actually, you know, two people had got COVID. So I was just lucky to get from out of there and get back home safe. And I think just telling the young players, just come in and just play your part. Don't come in trying to do overdue or just want to continuously stay in the gym to try to prove something. I think, you know, since being in the league for like 12 years now, I think if you just play your part and, you know, you have to pick up the things quick, especially being in the W, is way different than college where you take your time and you can actually have the time to work on things and learn new things. So with the W, you have to really learn things off the flip. So you have to be quick with how you learn. And I think that's pretty much what we, you know, are telling the young girls that's here.
And just to follow up, you said play your part. What do you see your part for DC being?
I think my part is just to come in, great energy, you know, do everything I've been doing since I've been in the league, whatever, you know, role coach want me to be in, whether that's me just sitting on the bench clapping for my teammates, just to bring that type of energy is what I'm here to do. I look forward to being with such a great team, a great organization. It's been great so far.
Kareem.
Hey, how are you today?
How are you?
Good. Ariel got a little bit of my question, but that's okay. I still got room. I wanted to ask, you know, you're obviously, you know, you've been around this league. You've seen, you know, the good, the bad, everything. So I'm just curious, what's your impression of this team? I know you guys only been together for a couple of days, but what are your initial impressions about this team, this roster? Just kind of when you sit down and look at it on paper.
I can't give you all the secrets right now. Nah, but
not all the tea. I get it.
We're looking good. I mean, we still have key pieces that's here, you know, with EDD, bringing Tina was huge. You know, with Taj leading the way. I think we're a solid group. And I think, you know, having a championship, you know, coach and a team, especially the people that was a part of their championship squad, that's still here, it makes it easy. You know, we all look for leadership, and I think everybody does their part in their own way.
Cool, quick and easy, thank you.
Thank you.
Lindsay?
Yeah, hi, welcome to DC. We're just, now we're the same age, I'm not gonna say that you're old, but as a veteran, okay? Where does that, motivation to keep getting better? You know, you're not on a team last summer, you've done so much in the WNBA, you've been on so many teams, you've won championships. Where does that motivation come from to say, hey, I don't want to stop this, I want to keep going, and I'm going to get even better?
I think one, the motivation comes within myself. When you a player, you know you still have a lot to give, regardless of somebody telling you things you can't do, i.e. that was, you know, what everybody was saying, oh, she's not a shooter. That kind of motivates you. It kind of makes you angry to a sense like, I can shoot. And it just makes you go in the gym and work on your game, honestly. So I think for me, I just honestly motivate myself because I know I still have a lot in the tank to give. So I just put the work in.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wilson?
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Doing good. I know you just kind of detailed the strengths of your game. You mentioned the work you put in on extending your range. How excited are you, you know, watching Coach T's offense from the outside to bring your skill set and your the work you put in on the three ball?
Oh, I'm excited. Are you to bring that in? I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
No, I'm good. You got it.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm excited. You know, actually trying to guard this team was very, very difficult because everybody can shoot. You have players that can get to the basket. And So when you add that dimension to your game, it makes it fun. So when you go out here and see, you know, from the outside looking in of the things you worked on and how I can implement with the system that he runs, it makes everything fun.
Christy, last question.
Thank you. Just really quickly, Shavonte, with you playing again with Tina Charles, you played with her in New York. What has this been for you the last couple of days to be on the floor with her in the same uniform this time?
It's great. It definitely gives you a familiar face you've been with for a long time. And it just makes it where it's a comfortability level. You know her, she know you. So like on certain plays or certain schemes, whether it's a defense or the offensive scheme, it's like we kind of have a connection a little bit because we have played, you know, 4 years with each other. So it makes it kind of fun. And actually seeing her, I felt like I haven't seen her in like 2 years. So it makes it fun.